Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Welcome, everyone, and what a game we have for you tonight. We're going to bring you the start of the preseason NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan at the table alongside Greg Anthony and Doris Burke. We'll be hearing from David Aldridge from the sideline. Home court advantage goes to the Mavericks playing here in the American Airlines Center. Beginning the exhibition season here today gives the fans, the coaches, and the players a chance to see some of the potential for the upcoming season.
And even though it's only preseason, a lot to look forward to from this game. You can tell who's been putting in the work in the offseason to improve on their game.
And before the game gets started, let's go to David Aldridge, who spoke with Rick Carlisle. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Well, it's the first meeting of the year between these teams, so he told me today is mainly a feeling out process, trying to identify strengths and weaknesses. We'll see how quickly they get a feel for this opponent. Kevin?
Thank you, David. And Doris, we're back at it again, ramping up for another exciting year of NBA basketball. When it comes to preseason, what do you enjoy most about watching these games?
Well, certainly you look to see the reaction of the rookies. Are they prepared to step up and contribute immediately? The development by the younger veterans, those that are starting to establish themselves in the NBA. And what do new coaches bring to their respective teams, Kev?
Tip-off goes to Milwaukee. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. Setting the floor for the Bucks. All the big Bucks up front. Giannis, Parker, and Maker. Ogden and Middleton are the guard tandem. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
Ref's calling it close already as he picks up a quick early foul.
Smith with it. Nowitzki outside. And here's Smith. Back to Nowitzki. From past the arc. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time. Nowitzki's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Barnes against Antetokounmpo. Off the screen. A shot. No good. And it's Dallas the other way. Fast break, Dallas. Barnes outside, kicks to Matthews. There's a screen by Noel, and there's the whistle, illegal screen.
And had the right idea there in calling for the screen, but he was just slow to get to the spot and didn't get set.
Yeah, just a matter of he needs to be there a split second earlier. Not much room for error when you're setting a screen.
And we watch Giannis out there. He just looked unstoppable, Greg, at times. The way he's able to attack the rim, the blend of size, speed, and length is just unparalleled in the NBA.
And it's the movement that throws you off with Giannis. One step, and he's gone from the three line to the rim. There isn't any way to stop someone that skilled who's that big.
Here's Barnes, following the basket by Chris Middleton. Back to Smith. Pass to Barnes. Shot clock at 6. Over onto Antetokounmpo. And that one comes up a bit short.
Well, the defense harassing him every step of the way makes that a really tough look.
The shot off that time. So the Mavericks will take it the other way. Barnes outside. The feed to Smith. Fires for 3. Sinks the triple.
When you think about his ability now to knock down these outside shots, with all of his force at attacking the rim, he's going to become unguardable.
Now here's Parker. Passes to Maker. Feeds to Antetokounmpo. And stolen by Barnes. And now Barnes running the floor all by himself. Some solid defense from Antetokounmpo.
Man, look at how well the defense does to cut his path to the basket. Comes up empty on what might have been an easy play.
It's rebounded by Dallas. Preseason game with Milwaukee. What a good look at the Bucks.
And they dominated this club last season. Looking to carry that over this season as well.
Gotta love Nowitzki setting his guys up with perfect passes.
Bucks trail by six. Brogdon kicks to Parker. And it's out of the Kumbo, top of the key. And it's good on the assist by Parker.
Yeah, good awareness there. He sees an opening and doesn't hesitate.
And that's not the type of defense you want to play, right? You've got to make it more difficult than that. Layups are too easy.
Now, here is Smith. He's got five. There's a screen by Noel. Down to five on the shot clock.
Don't you love how Noel just sticks with it, never gives up on the possession, working really hard for his guys.
5 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Antetokounmpo passes to make it. Nice ball movement by Milwaukee. And it's Antetokounmpo penetrated. That one, no good. Good D by Barnes. Here's Smith. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup. Smith's got seven.
And this is one of Smith's strengths, his ability to attack and cut through the defense and just finishing with ease at the rim.
And so it's the Dallas Mavericks in the driver's seat, up 8 points at the end of the quarter. Defensively, they have gotten after it, contesting every shot going up. Right back after this break. And Dirk Nowitzki steadily climbing the all-time scoring rankings. He talked about the remarkable journey of his long and illustrious career.
When I first got here, you know, my first year was so tough that I didn't really know that I can make it in this league. You know, to be named with all these names is an unbelievable honor, and it's been a crazy ride.
Dirk has proven himself through the test of time. As tough as it may have been back in his rookie year, he overcame those obstacles to become this elite NBA player destined for the Hall of Fame.
And people do talk about players being a Dirk Nowitzki type. You're right about that. And that's a type any team would like to have. You know, one of the greatest power forwards in the NBA's history.
The NBA preseason action continues here on 2K Sports. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Mavericks?
Listen, early on taking the league, I just like their approach offensively.
I think their play calling has been exceptional. They've played with purpose, and they've played with aggressiveness.
Setting the floor for the Bucks. Parker is the four with Monroe in the middle. Matthew Dellavedova is out there with Chris Middleton, and it's Snell in at the three spot. Doris, what an honor, inducted into your college's Hall of Fame, something not many of us can say. What does that kind of honor do for the confidence for you personally going forward?
You know what, Providence College is a place that means a great deal to me. So what that Hall of Fame induction did was just remind me of all the special memories that I shared with my teammates. I'm close with many of them today. And Kevin, you know this, you know, if you've ever been inside a locker room, it's those moments when you're laughing until your stomach hurts. I'd say we were the Hall of Fame fun team. That's what I'd say.
I think we're on the fun team here on 2K.
And you can see there the defender gets caught up on the pick.
Well, you simply got to push through that, right? You need to at least contest the shot. Otherwise, he's going to knock it down.
Now, here's Barea. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Free throw line jump shot. And the shot is long. Middleton against Barea. Middleton dishes to Dellavedova. To the wing on the left. It's Parker outside. They get it back. Monroe. A shot by Middleton. Wide open. Gets an open look and hits. Yes. Middleton's got 5 points in the quarter.
And good passing setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Curry kicks to Barnes. Finney Smith passes to Barnes. Over Parker. Here's Mejri. And again, unable to change momentum here. Milwaukee has gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. And Middleton kicks to Monroe. Good D by Barnes.
And typically he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
But how about Salah Mejri, the first ever player from the NBA out of Tunisia? 7'2" shot blocker with extensive playing experience overseas.
Shakes his man by using exceptional use of the screen. I mean, from there, it's smooth sailing.
And Dallas calls their first timeout of the game. And speaking of Mejri's international experience, he was a 29-year-old rookie in 2015.
Right, Mejri is a guy, it took him a while to make his way to the NBA, but he has shown he belongs. Guy's pretty mobile for his size, a really solid rebounder, good rim runner off the pick and roll. Lot to like about him.
And his guys are getting frustrated. Coach just really kind of needs to calm them down.
I think, Greg, they've got to continue to believe that the next shot is going to go in. He can hopefully communicate that effectively to them.
And it's a completely new group on the floor for the Mavericks. The Bucks also changing it up. Akers checked in for Jabari Parker. Giannis Antetokounmpo comes in for Tony Snell. And Malcolm Brogdon subbed in for Chris Middleton. Now here's Matthews. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Trains the three-pointer.
Wow, look at the way the big man, Noel, set up his guys, puts the pass in the perfect position, easy shot.
And here is Dellavedova. After Dennis Smith was able to get the three, Dellavedova kicks to Antetokounmpo. And good, got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. Antetokounmpo's got it all tied up now for Milwaukee. Dallas has gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc so far tonight. Nowitzki a screen, pass to Matthews. Noel, a screen on Antetokounmpo. From 6 away. And it's finished off by Nowitzki as he lays it in. Nowitzki's got 5 now.
God, that's just great persistence from Nowitzki. Tracks down the offensive board thanks to his outstanding positioning.
5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Here's Antetokounmpo. It's hauled in by Nowitzki.
Well, he gets the separation he needs. You can't say the same for his aim, though.
Here's Farrell. Smith outside. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Dirk Nowitzki. And now a 5-point Dallas lead. No good on that one. And the first half comes to a conclusion in a game that has been very close so far. Mavericks lead by 5. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thank you. Nerlens, a big factor in that first half. What was the key?
You know, just asserting myself, you know, on the defensive and offensive end. You know, just got to get myself going, you know, keep my teammates involved. You know, I want a few of my teammates, you know, make sure we're playing up-paced basketball and, you know, just getting up and down.
That is the key for your success so far. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks so much, Dave, for the great interview. Don't go away, folks. We'll be back for the second half of basketball right after this.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back to this preseason edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson, Shaq, Kenny the Jet. Big time play throughout the first half from Dennis Smith. He had 13 points and 1 assist. And Kenny, what are your thoughts on how Dallas played?
Well, they were lighting it up from 3, and that was the difference in the first half. They did a good job of running off screen, spotting up, and getting rid of the ball quickly. And their shot selection, solid.
And you, big fella, let's get your thoughts on the Bucks.
Well, they had a hard time scoring inside. In fact, their offense was run almost exclusively along the perimeter. A lot of jumpers. It's too predictable. You got to mix it up.
And that wraps up the halftime show. Third quarter set to begin in just a few.
The skyline of Dallas illuminating the night sky as we welcome you back to the Lone Star State. NBA preseason action underway once again. Glad to have you with us. A fantastic game from Dennis Smith in this one.
Yeah, so far they haven't found an answer for him, a scoring machine here in that first half.
And it's mattered not, Greg, whether he's been spotting up or creating for himself. He was unstoppable, and you hope it carries over to the second half.
And so it's Dallas with it. It's a five-point game. Greg, the Bucks can be a fearsome defense when things are clicking.
And the Bucks will do it with several approaches. I mean, great numbers in terms of steals and blocks. They force a lot of turnovers with their pressure and ball hawking skill. It's just a matter of when the offense can catch up to the defense.
Smith Jr. runs the point with Matthews at his side. They're the backcourt. Okay. Dirk is the four with Noel manning the middle. And it's Barnes in at the three spot. So that's who Rick Carlisle starts the second half with. That's good from Noel.
Well, the Mavericks last season, remember, went 33-49. It was their first losing season in 17 years. That's a remarkable record of winning.
Both free throws good from Noel. And in the midst of their 16 seasons of 500 basketball or better, the Mavericks with 11 straight seasons of 50 wins or better.
And they have 12 of those 50-win seasons overall, Kev. Everyone knows they've got an NBA title underneath their belt. If you're a Dallas Mavericks fan, you have every reason to be proud.
Nobody near Barnes. Doesn't go that time. And Milwaukee the other way now. There's the dish to Antetokounmpo. Good D by Barnes. Mavericks leading by 7. Smith the pass to Matthews. Second half just getting started, about a minute played. Stolen by Middleton. Now the Bucks moving it up. A shot by Brogdon, wide open. Good, and the assist goes to Middleton. Middleton's got 3 assists tonight. Dallas has gone 4-6 from outside the arc tonight. Smith on the wing from downtown. Antetokounmpo pulls it in. Bucks trail by 5. 90 seconds now into the second half. Middleton. Here's Maker. And, there's a whistle. He was going up for a layup. And while it looked like there was some contact, I wasn't sure they were going to call it a foul shot or not. But sure enough, they have. So he'll head to the free throw line. The Bucks shooting their first foul shot of the night. And a new group getting ready for Dallas. Measury, he's checked in for Noel. Dorian Finney-Smith comes in for Dirk Nowitzki. Seth Curry, he's checked in for Wesley Matthews. And Barea subbed in for Smith. Tony Snell's checked in for Milwaukee.
One shot.
Free throw good from Maker. And there are so many great point guards in the league. In fact, the number of stars at that position, you see them every night, but who are some of the floor generals that maybe don't get the headlines? More of the underrated portion.
I think the single most consistently underrated point guard, though certainly not by the contract extension he most recently signed, would be Mike Conley. This guy for the Memphis Grizzlies. Some guys just fit in the systems and the cities and the organizations for whom they play. And I would say Mike Conley, ability to run the team, ability to make the three-point shot, to make the players around him better, he comes to mind. Kemba Walker in Charlotte is a guy who, once they consistently start to make the playoffs as an undersized point guard, I think you could see him start to grow in reputation. And Isaiah Thomas, who launched himself for stretches into the MVP conversation. Interestingly, Kevin, what do all three have in common? A little bit undersized in today's NBA.
And can you believe Conley has never been an All-Star as good as he is?
Cannot believe that. No, and you've had his teammates make it, Marc Gasol most notably.
I know that Marc Gasol would love to see Mike Conley next to him in an All-Star uniform.
A different look for Dallas. Nowitzki comes in for measure. And Yogi Ferrell subbed in for Dorian Finney-Smith. Greg Monroe, he's checked in for Milwaukee. Matthew Dellavedova comes in for Malcolm Brogdon. Here's Ferrell. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Nowitzki a screen. Outside Curry. He feeds it to Nowitzki. Four on the shot clock. Pulled the shot a little left, but the bounce goes his way. Nowitzki's got his third basket of the night. And that's a foul. They're called on Yogi Ferrell. That is his first foul of the game.
Man, it's close, but, you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
Now here is Dellavedova. He's tightly guarded. There's the screen. Monroe with a screen on Curry. Shot clock at six.
Well, terrific defense from Dirk. Takes the perfect angle to contest perfectly.
It's stolen by Barea.
Yeah, that's two really unproductive trips in a row ending in turnover.
Now the pass to Nowitzki. Barnes dishes to Curry. A steal. Here's Snell, guarded by Curry. Snell, that's good.
If you're going in amongst the trees, you have got to be aggressive.
Well, he went all in there. He embraces the challenge and somehow finishes with the layup.
Now Barea. Ferrell for three. Good, and it's Barea who picks up the assist. And the Mavericks lead by three. It's still anybody's game as we reach the end of three. The Mavericks on top. They're up by three. And time for the short break, and stay right where you are. The fourth quarter is coming up next. Rick Carlisle had some words for his team. Let's hear what he had to say.
Got to have a presence in the lane. Remember, no layups, no layups, no layups.
Rick Carlisle making rim protection a key priority. You heard right there. We'll see if they can really shut down the paint.
And to achieve what the coach wants, it's going to take a lot of communication defensively. Guys helping one another on the floor.
Thanks for being with us as we get going here once again. A preview of the upcoming NBA season ahead. On the floor for Milwaukee, starting the fourth quarter. On the perimeter, it's Middleton and Giannis. Parker is the four with Monroe in the middle. And it's Dellavedova in at the point guard position. Now, Antetokounmpo, following the three-point attempt by Dennis Smith. Tries a three. Here's Monroe. It counts, and the foul. It's going to be on Nerlens Noel.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebounding advantage is starting to add up.
And the Mavericks, one of the more forward-thinking franchises in the NBA. They were among the first, Doris, to embrace analytics.
Well, listen, this is an organization that ownership has a background in technology, so it makes sense for them to grasp onto those analytics. But for me, it's about combining that with the fierce competitiveness and a team hungry to find every edge.
Dallas has gone 5 of 10 from downtown tonight, 50% exactly. Ferrell kicks to Noel. There's the pick. Back to Ferrell. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. That one on Monroe. And Yogi Ferrell, undrafted out of Indiana, parlayed a strong 10-day performance contract with the Mavericks last season into a 2-year deal.
And how about in his first game with the Mavs, he starts and leads them to their first victory in San Antonio since 2011. And what does he do for an encore? Just drop 32 on Portland, including a rookie record 9 threes. That's what you call doing work.
And the first one at the line is good. Malcolm Brogdon's checked in for the Bucks. So he gets them both.
And you look at the Bucks in this roster, and the one constant at every position, length. I mean, great height and wingspan. Giannis and Maker, just to name a few.
For three, Middleton, and the rebound goes to Nowitzki. The Mavericks leading. Just over a minute played here in the fourth. Smith kicks to Farrell. Mavericks with the new shot clock. There's Noel. They had a number of cracks at it, but came away empty-handed. Milwaukee has gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Brogdon against Nowitzki. Brogdon kicks to Parker. Clock at six. Shoots from the elbow. And good, and it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down. Parker's got the game tied up here for the Bucks. And when so much of the NBA is trying to capitalize, Greg, on small ball, the Bucks said they're going to go for tall ball if they can make it work.
And what the length and height gives the Bucks is a few things. One, you get matchup advantages at least at a few positions on the floor. Great coverage in the passing lanes. And remember now, the game, the half court is much bigger because of the impact of the three-point shot. You need size, skill, and activity to be able to guard that far from the basket. A blown opportunity after the two-man game creates a terrific look.
Well, he simply misfired. You've got to capitalize when the screen opens up wide open shots like that.
And a great assist by Brogdon as that one goes in. 6 points for Parker.
A good score inside, and the defense really offering very little resistance.
They've got to be willing to step up. And when it's this close, you just can't let them get easy buckets. Make them feel you a bit.
Dallas calls timeout. They trail by two. 1:35 left in the fourth quarter. We've got a moment for our Jordan player of the game, Chris Middleton.
And the shooting percentage, how about all the way in the 60s, shows how deadly he can be when he's feeling it. And as locked in as he was, they were trying to feed him as much as possible. But he never got out of control. I mean, he kept his head and just stayed patient.
He's checked in for the Mavericks. Correa comes in for Smith. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Hey, Kevin, I heard Rick Carlisle during that last break talking with the team. He wants to change it up defensively and get more people packed into the paint. He said they're beating us up down low. We have to put a stop to it. Let's see if they respond, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Now, here's Correa. He dishes it to Nowitzki. Noel passes to Barnes. Dallas, no good that time either. Milwaukee in the lead. Around 3 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Count the basket.
Oh, he is one hard player to deal with at the offensive end.
There's a minute left to play here in the fourth. Matthews, a screen on Middleton. Got a piece of it. Here's Barnes. It's in! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
Fearless, decisive, on point.
Which is exactly what you have to be, especially when your team needs a bucket.
Monroe dishes to Middleton. Nice ball movement by Milwaukee.
Still a chance here, but they need to score.
They cannot afford to waste a single possession at this point. The heat is on, and Matthews comes alive. His shot-making ability in these situations is downright crazy.
And the replay is courtesy of Under Armour. Unleash chaos. It was a great sequence from the steal all the way to the finish at the other end. Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. There's 25 seconds left in the game. Ogden against Berea. Now, here's Brogdon. Middleton with a screen for Brogdon. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Here's Antetokounmpo. No good. And the Mavericks call time here. The score knotted at 33. 3 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. And here's Matthews for the three. Oh, no good there. The potential game winner off the mark. And that's going to do it for regulation. So we are headed to overtime. And we'll get going after this from the American Airlines Center. Well, if you're just joining us, the intensity has really heated up in this one. As we watch this one go now to overtime.
Ladies and gentlemen, ready?
So the Bucks win the tip. And away we go here with post-regulation basketball. All fueled up and ready to go to overtime basketball here, brought to us by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. And Milwaukee, looking at who they've got. All the big bucks up front. Giannis, Parker, and Maker. Ogden and Middleton are the guard tandem. Here's Berea. Giannis Antetokounmpo making his last shot. Nowitzki a screen. Barnes kicks to Berea. Down low. Six to shoot. Dishes it to Barnes. Lets it fly. And right through it goes. Barnes has got the game tied up here for the Mavs.
Oh, Kevin, that is absolutely monumental. And you have to admire the way Barnes carries himself right now. Very few antics, just goes about his business.
Now here's Middleton. Here's Antetokounmpo. Good, and the assist goes to Middleton. That's 12 points for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
And that one really took the air out of this crowd.
Just like that. I mean, you can hear a pin drop in here.
There's a screen by Noel. From the baseline. Off the left rim and out.
And as he squares up for mid-range, the defender right in his face.
Well, classic example of crowding the shooter, not letting him get comfortable in the mid-range.
So, guys, it comes down to this.
Time for your stars to shine.
Oh, this team needs a bucket. Matthew steps up, puts them on his back, and delivers.
Timeout called, the Bucks. Checked in for Dallas. To the middle. Shot from 12. There's Maker. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
Way to attack there and then create the contact.
He knocks down the clutch free throw. Gets them both, and it's a two-point ball game.
Yeah, critical that he's able to convert there. Now they've taken the lead.
Dallas calls timeout. They trail by two. There's 37 seconds left to play in the first overtime. Guys, what do you think?
And looking at how much time they have, I think it's likely we'll see them try to get a good look and score quickly.
Nowitzki, the pass to Smith. Shoots it up. Quick shot there, and it's off target. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Antetokounmpo against Barnes. Outside, Antetokounmpo. Six on the shot clock. 13 feet away. Barnes grabs the miss, and the Mavericks call time here. They're behind by two. 8 seconds left to play in OT, and this battle continuing. Guys, your thoughts?
And it all comes down to this. Still enough time on the clock that they should be able to get a real good look.
My question is, will they go for the two to tie or three to win?
Smith for three. No good from three-point territory. And so they choose to intentionally foul.
You know what? Smart foul. You got to try and extend the game.
Gentlemen, two shots. Loose shot.
It's the first, and that makes it a three-point lead. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a four-point ball game.
Those free throws are the nail in the coffin, guys.
Off target. So a close game sees Milwaukee taking this one. They had to scrape and claw to push it to overtime, but they really came on in the extra period.
What a ride. I mean, I thought it might end in regulation, but you know what? They came through big and did exactly what was necessary once we got into OT.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. With Greg Monroe here, and Greg, what in the game plan allowed you to get this win tonight?
Well, I'm not sure how many turnovers we had, but we definitely want to limit that. And we wanted to make sure that we were in good position as far as defensively. We were always at help side. I think we did a good job of that tonight.
Yeah, you put a real wall in front of them all night, Greg. Thanks for your time. Kevin, back to you.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. And that about wraps up this first game of the NBA preseason. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. See you later.